In a previous tutorial video, we talked about creating motion tweens with property changes. A motion tween somewhat implies that an object is moving. But a motion tween is much more than that. You don't necessarily have to have the object move, or you can have it move and also change other properties such as size and color, and you can do a special effect or rotate it. And when we did that video, we created a star movie clip symbol and a motion tween that has many keyframes. And as we watch, it's going to go from small to big, from top left to bottom right. It changes color, it adds some glow effects, and it rotates. So this was created by moving our playhead to a certain point, clicking on our symbol, and then modifying whatever property we wanted to modify, and then repeating. So if I wanted to move to my last keyframe, I'd click on the symbol and then modify whatever property I was working on. Now this wasn't too bad, but imagine you were doing this for several different items in your project. This could get really tedious. So Flash has created something called Motion Editor, and this is going to allow you to do all your property changes in one area. Let's see how this works. I've created a new project with a basic star on the stage, and we need to convert this to a movie clip symbol so that we can animate it. And then we'll go to Insert, Motion Tween, and we'll stretch that motion tween out to about the 60th frame. So even though we have a motion tween right now, we only have one keyframe, so there's nothing that's actually animated. And we're going to click on the motion editor, which can be found near the timeline. So we'll go ahead and grab our object. And as you can see, we have a bunch of collapsible sections here. And these are the different properties that you can change. So you can change the basic motion, which is the X and Y coordinates and the rotation of it. You can transform it so you can skew it and scale it. Add a color effect such as fading it in or fading it out or changing the tint of it. Add filters such as drop shadows or strokes or outer glow. And then you can create easing effects. So all of your different property changes are in this one area. What I'm looking at right here is the equivalent of the timeline. My animation is 60 frames, so right now I'm seeing 60 frames. Sometimes when you come into the animation area, you can't see all the frames, or it's just not working out for you as well as you had hoped. And that's when you come down here to this area to see your different viewing options. Mostly you're going to deal with the graph size, which is going to change how big each of these properties are vertically. And then you're going to deal with how many frames are viewable at a time. So right now I have 24 frames viewable at a time, so it's only showing me about half my project. If I wanted to, I could expand that up to 60 so I could see what's happening throughout the life of this animation. Now it's just a matter of moving my playhead and changing a property. So on the first frame, I want my star to be there. And on the 60th frame, I want it to be here. And as you can see, we've changed the X coordinates, X and Y coordinates, and we're seeing a difference in keyframe. A little keyframe is this black dot right here, and then a solid line is showing motion. So we've moved it that way. So let's go back to frame one, and let's say we want to do rotations. So by the 60th frame, I want it to have rotated a couple of times. So I can do, there we go. So there's my rotation. And then transformation, I'll go ahead and collapse the basic motion. And transformation, let's say at this point, I actually want it to be pretty small. So I can scale it. And because my playhead is on frame one, now it's at 28%. And then I can move over to frame 60 and make it 100%. And it looks like my motion's a little bit off. I wanted it to actually start at the beginning, so I can go back to basic motion. And I can just edit it right here, and it'll automatically change the X values for that symbol. So now we've got it rotating, it's getting bigger, and it's moving across the screen. So we can do a couple other things. Now be aware with these symbols, you can only add one color effect and only one filter. So I can do tint, and this is going to change the tint or the color of my actual object. and the strength of that tint you can change here. So at this point, the tint color is blue, and I'm just going to change it back to 0 so that even though it says blue, it's 0%. So then by, let's say, the 10th frame, let's say I want it to be blue, and by the 20th frame, I can say it needs to be green, and by the 30th frame, oops, and see, I got to create a keyframe. So by this point, if you click this keyframe, so this one was supposed to be blue, this little keyframe thing right here, it's a little button that can add a keyframe. So I want my property of blue and 100% to be changed right here. And then I want my property of green to be green and 100% right here. So then by 30, let's say I want to change it to pink, and it automatically creates a keyframe because I changed the color right here, but it doesn't create a keyframe for the 100% because I didn't change anything about that. So it's going to go from green to pink, and then we can do, let's do orange, and then let's do purple, purple-ish. And by the last keyframe, we can have it go back to yellow. So let's see how that works. Okay, so we're doing a lot of property changes without having to worry about it over here and seeing them all together in one. So the last property change we'll create, we will do a special effect of glow. And it's going to ask you, these are all the various subcategories of the glow property that you can change. So remember, we've got keyframes for whichever ones we're changing. So right now, the blur is red tint, so I'll go ahead and change that to white. And I want it to be 0, so it doesn't look like anything's happening. But maybe by the 10th frame, I want it to be 100. And then by the 20th frame, maybe I want this to be 0. And 30, I want it to be 100, or I can make it a little bit bigger. And pull that down. So it's a really subtle glow change. But we can add that effect in there. So that's the basics of working with the motion editor. It just allows you to do not just motion, but size and various other property changes all in one area. And then just remember, once you create that tween the exact way that you want it, let's say you wanted to apply that to maybe another star or to a different object altogether, don't forget that you can right click and you can do copy motion and then paste that motion onto another layer with another object.